Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video, which is going to be trying new makeup in Dutch, kinda. And if you're new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent, and I am here to show you how to be fabulous in your 40s, or something like that. Yes, I don't really know what I wanted to say, but if you like makeup, if you want to learn how to get into makeup, if you like colorful makeup, if you want to learn how to use different color combinations, or maybe you just want to get inspired, or I don't know, you just love someone putting on makeup, then this is definitely the channel for you, because that's what we are going to do today. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and become part of my nestlings, because we are the bestest. Yes. I have new makeup here. I already said that, right? Yeah, and the reason that I thought let me also throw in some Dutch today is because I got a new eyeshadow palette in. And that is the Starry Night from Storybook Cosmetics. Now, if you don't know, the Starry Night was painted by Vincent van Gogh. And Vincent van Gogh is a Dutch painter. So I thought, let's do something with that. I have a new bronzer. I have a new blush and a new highlighter. And I have a new eyeshadow palette. And that's basically it. Do I also have a new lippy? Let me check. Not really. Yeah, I do. But I don't think that it will go with the look of today, so we're not going to use it. Okay, let's start with the bronzer that I have. I actually ordered a bronzer from CXC Beauty, which is the Defined Radiance Olive 2. Because if you are new, I'm also a light olive, or light medium olive, because I have kind of tanned a little bit. Not that I particularly go out to tan, but stuff happened. And this is, well, supposed to be an olive-y one. So I have already swatched it. So here is the shade. And I can also kind of show you against the Bahama Mama that I have here. So this is the comparison between the two. So I feel like this one from CXC is maybe a little bit more warm toned than the Bahama Mama. But I'm going to try it right now. Let me get a brush. So let's, ooh, it picks up a lot on this brush. So let's tap off a little bit. And let's kind of tap on a little bit on. Now there is, this is olive too, so there is a lighter one as well. But I thought maybe, because I'm not very, very pale, maybe number two would be better for me. So it is on one half of my face. It looks pretty. And I think there are four shades in the olive spectrum. He has cool toned, warm toned. I don't know if he also has neutral, but I know that he also has olive. So I was like, huh, oh, that is interesting. It looks to be a nice color though. Blends out nicely. It looks pretty. Yeah, let me compare swatch it to the Bahama Mama so that you guys have a reference. If my arm wants to hold on to the swatch, because I swatched the palette and yeah, my arm is very much exfoliated right now. Let's just say that. So here they are, and the Bahama Mama is kind of blended out maybe a little bit more. Let me kind of see if I can build it up a bit. But you don't really do that, right? So let me blend them out a tad. Maybe that will help. So I don't know if this is helpful for you guys, but this is the Bahama Mama and this is the CXC bronzer, which is warmer, and the Bahama Mama is more cool tone. So I hope this helps. But it's not, I feel, as orange as other bronzers that I have. So not that I have a lot of bronzers left. So yes, formula feels nice to blend out. It is pretty pigmented, so I think that if you are a medium, you can still use this. Tan, it will probably be very, very subtle color-wise. But if you are light, fair to light, this one is too pigmented for you, I think at least. Let's go next to, shall I do the highlighter as a blush topper? No, I want to do the highlighter first so you can see it. So I received in PR two products from DJ's Unique Boutique. A loose highlighter and a shimmery blush. So let's start with the loose highlighter. There's also a thing that I took out. Yeah, that's it. I took it out. So I'm actually, let me get my Nabla brush. It's going to be a thing. So I'm very, very carefully picking up. And then I'm just tapping off my brush. Now, when I swatched this, oh, it's so pretty. It kind of reminded me a little bit of the Mars Melter from Kaleidos. But on me, I have swatched it, and it's basically a red. There's red. It's a fiery one. DJ's Unique Boutique is owned by one of my friends here on YouTube. And I will leave her channel down below, just PGD, and she is of a darker skin tone, so that's why how the products are formulated as well. So if you are of a deeper complexion, this will look stunning. But I also think that if you are light, it will look stunning. I think it looks very, very pretty. Now, I love a highlighter that is deeper. I don't like an icy highlighter on me. It's just not pretty. It's not what I go for. But I think this looks gorgeous. This looks stunning. Now, what I usually love to do is kind of blend it down a little bit. As for instance a blush topper. Especially now that I have the Fenty Skin Tint on. This is sometimes just a look. To use something like this as a blush topper. It's very, very pretty. But we are not done. Because I also received her blush. Which is the newest one. And it's gorgeous. It did come a bit broken. So please don't mind how it looks. This is how it looks. Can you see the shift? So it is a shimmer blush with a... It's almost a cooler toned... It's... kind of weird, because when I look at it, I see that it has some blue in it, but and when I swatch it and I blend it out, I can see there's blue in it as well, but there's also orange and fiery, and I cannot wait to put this on the face. I do think I need a brush that is synthetic though. And why do I say that? Just because of I know that this is formulated for a darker skin tone. And if I use a real hairbrush, it will pick up a crap ton. So I'm just going to go... This is one swipe. Yes. So I'm going to tap off a bit. Very, very much so. Let's be gentle. I would rather build it up. Oh, oh, oh. So basically one dip. If you are light... Maybe this is a little bit too hefty for you, unless you like that, of course. For me, this is a gentle pat or gentle tap. And I get this. Okay, now I kind of want to tone it down a tad, because it's not a look I go for today, at least, I think. But you never know. So I'm just tapping over it with my sponge a bit that I used for foundation. Okay, and what I can also do if I want to tone it down a tad more is just buff over it with powder. But yeah, it's very, very, very pretty. Very, very pretty. And this can be a gorgeous, gorgeous eyeshadow too. Just saying. So yeah, I have more of her things here. And I think that the quality is just amazing. The component, I did not even show you the component. It looks very, very pretty as well. And this is a double one. So underneath here, there is space for, I don't know, a powder puff or something like that. So, but oh my lord. Thank you so, so very much for sending them to me, because they're so, so pretty. Yes, that was the newness that I have so far, I think. Yes, and then it's eyeshadow time. So let me kind of tell you what bronzer is in Dutch. Bronzer. That's not really difficult. Highlighter is highlighter. And a blush, right now we are calling it blush as well. But we used to call it rouge. Rouge. And rouge is basically the French word for blush. But it's also the French word for red. So it's very, you know, rouge. Yes, you learned something. Let's go to the eyeshadow palette. So, let me show you the close-ups as well. It's so, so stunning. When I saw this palette released, because it's an older palette, I think this released last year. When I saw it, I said, I need it. I distinctly remember saying that in the video where I talked about it, that's the Let's Talk Makeup, that I mentioned this palette in last year. The trouble was though, it's 60 bucks and with shipping and I thought also import tax. I was like, it's too expensive for me. I'm going to wait for a sale because it will be mine. Well, they had a 50% sale not too long ago, or at least this palette was 50% off. So I got me one. I love Storybook Cosmetics aesthetic. I love the fact that it looks like a book. I find this color story so interesting and so inspiring. I feel like they truly captured the colors of the painting, and I know that Musée Beauty also did a Starry Night. Honestly, I like this one better color story wise. I feel like it is, yeah, it fits better. But that is my thing. Now my plan for today is to do a blue look with I think I'm going to do the chartreuse, or shall I do the chartreuse in the inner eye part area and then the blue on the outside, and then I think I'm going to do the orange on the lid. That was kind of the plan idea a little bit. But let me get brushes first. Oh yeah, I also need to prime my eyes. What's the primer I want to use today? Now one of you actually asked in the comment section if I had any, well, basically recommendations for eyeshadow bases for older eyes. My recommendation is look for texture. Look for a thin texture. That's it, at least for me. Now my eyelids aren't oily or anything, but I want something that I can, like I'm doing right now, tap on my eyes instead of I need to blend. So for instance, the Sigma stick that I have, I kind of need to blend more. I don't really want that. And the MAC Paint Pot is also more along the lines of that waxy consistency, you know. I prefer, at least right now, I prefer something that is a little bit thinner in texture. So for instance, this one from Kiko Milano, and the Natasha Denona one is thinner, the ABH one is thinner. Those are basically the primers, or the one from Catrice that I have here, but you can only get that here in the Netherlands or in Europe. But the other one from Catrice in the tube is also a thinner consistency. And that is, I feel, when you're older, thin layers is the way to go. That's how I feel. I hope that was helpful. Okay, let's get me some brushes. I want to start with, what am I going to start with? I want to start with the shade Man. And that is Dutch for Moon. And the shade Man is the chartreuse one, which will probably be more yellow for me, because that is what happens for me and chartreuse. I'm going to put that here and a little bit more in the inner. I feel like I almost have to do a blue look with this, you know, because the painting is very, very blue heavy. When I looked up where Vincent van Gogh lived, where he was born and all that, he's actually born in Zundert, which is in Brabant, and that's close to Belgium for us. Fun fact, and most of you don't know this, but the family on my father's side is from Brabant. And I actually have family living in Zundert, so that's fun. So when I was reading up on that, I was like, ooh, I've been there. Ooh, I know that place, which is actually pretty, pretty fun. It's the greenest chartreuse on me that I have. Usually they pull very, very yellow. It's also the base that I have right now, because that base from Kiko is a little bit more on the olive side. Okay, the next shade I think I'm going to go to is, I think I'm going to go to Cyprus, which is how we say it. It's Cyprus, and that is the tree, one of the trees that is in the painting. I think this is one. I don't know. It was a Cyprus tree. So Cyprus. But Cyprus is also an island. I don't know. Never mind. So this is the shade, Cyprus. It's the lightest of the blue. Let me go over the shade names, because I think that will be fun. So basically 1853, which is the first, I'm going to put it here, which is the first shade. It's the year that he was born. And if I were to say it in Dutch, it would be 1853. So how do we say it? We say 18 and then 3 and 50. That's actually how we say it. I'm just going to tap the shade that I have now, which is Cyprus or Cyprus. Now, what I noticed with this palette is that actually most of the names are in Dutch, but there are also some names written in English, and I don't know why. Because Cyprus, as it is written here, it's the English way, because we write it with an I instead of a Y. So I don't really know why they did that. I checked on the website and there was not really anything more about the palette or on the inspiration, and I did not feel like searching the Instagram post about it actually. Now then we get next to shade 1853, we have the shade Venus, and Venus is how we say Venus, and that's the planet, because in his Starry Night paintings he paints the planet Venus, or at least that's what I found online. Then the shade next to it is Maan, which is the Dutch word for moon, which is the shade that I have in my inner corner. And yeah, it's a very prominent shade here, or at least a prominent part of the picture, painting, whatever, yes. Okay, I want a little bit of the shade Maan. Then we get the shade Theo, and how would we pronounce it? Theo. So instead of the, we just have a T. So yeah, it's not Theo, it's Theo. And that's his brother. One of his brothers, actually. The one that he is very much in contact with. The shade after that is Cyprus, the shade that I have been using. Then we have the shade Rustig. And Rustig is the Dutch word for calm, or sometimes slow. It kind of depends on what it is used in. So if I feel calm, or if I am calm, I am rustig. If I travel slow, I can also use the word rustig, if that makes any sense at all. Probably not. And then the shade Firmament, which is the black, or is it a black? Maybe if, I don't know. It's a black, but it's kind of a muted black. Firmament is, oh yeah, the expanse. So it's not, or the heavens. So it's not the night sky, it is the heavens. That's firmament. It's basically the thing that holds the stars. Because that was not, that was the sky, but it's more than the sky. It's, yeah, I don't know. I am actually going to go to this shade called Hemel. And Hemel is, you can translate that a few ways. You can translate it as heaven. So this is the shade Hemel. You can translate it in heaven, because also when we are talking about heaven, we call it de hemel. But it's also another word for sky. So the night sky, for instance, you know. I'm going to use this to deepen up. And you can already see that this is turning a little bit more of a teal. It's the nature of the shade combined with my undertone and the base I used underneath, I think, a bit. Then the shade next to it is the shade Vincent, which is, well, his name, you know, Vincent. And that's it, the way that we pronounce it isn't that different from English. The shade after that is called Window. And here I am lost again, because our Dutch word for window is raam. And I know why they called a shade that, but I don't understand why they did not name it raam, because all the other shades are basically in Dutch, you know. Why not this shade as well? I don't understand that, but they will probably have had a good reason for it. I don't know, maybe it's a funky word in English that I don't know about. But basically he painted this picture from his window, so it was what he could see. Okay, then we have the shade Juni, which is June, and that is the month that the painting was painted, if I am not mistaken. And then the last shade is called Nocturna, and that's basically nocturnal. That's, you know, you have that word as well, only in Dutch we say Nocturna. I kind of want to use the shade Venus as well, so let's go to, let's go to Venus, this one. And I think I'm going to put that underneath my eye. Next, I'm going to go to the shade Firmament, which is this one. I do feel that these shades have a tendency to get patchy. So if you see that happening with shades, and it is not weird with shades like this, just tap over instead of blend if you find you have difficulty with them. Just don't overblend. I'm going to go to the shade 1853, which is this one, which is the dark blue. It is a shimmer, but it is basically your old school shimmer. I'm going to use it dry because I want it here. I want the shimmeriness here. And I want a little bit of the contrast between the blue that basically pulls a little bit green on me. And the orange I'm going to use a little later. Okay, so I changed my mind, which I'm very, very prone to do. It's not really weird. I'm going to go to the shade Vincent. Because I cannot use a palette about Vincent van Gogh and then not use the shade that he's named after. Jenne. So yeah. Oh, that's nice. It's dry, by the way. It's a very pretty shade. Oh, very, very pretty. Very, very pretty. I'm actually curious to see what happens when I spray it. So basically, I'm loading up my brush with the shade. Then I'm going to spray. It's just some water in here. And then, let's see. I don't use a... Ooh, that's pretty. I don't use a shimmer primer because I feel that it creases my shadows. Especially in summer. I am going to go to the shade Venus. Just a little. For here. Just to blend it over a bit. Can I not put the green over the shade? Maybe. Let's see if I can achieve what I want. A small brush, but not too dense, I think. I'm going to go to the shade Uni. Let's see if I can, what happens when I put it over the shade Man. It should make everything a little bit more green. Let's put it in the inner corner, on the lid. Yeah, it makes it a little bit more green and maybe not as chartreusey. Okay, so let's go back to the shade Man. Let's see if I can chartreuse it or yellowy it up a little. Not really, but that is okay. I really, really need to use the shade Window or Raam. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab an orange eye pencil. Shall we also do the green? Because then I think I have almost all the shades. So I'm going to go next to the shade called Nocturne first. To meet up with the blue that I have. Let's be funky. The shade Window is a very, very nice orange. Very fiery orange. Now, because of what I did, it's not really picking up the orange, unfortunately. But maybe we can spruce it up a little bit. So now I am grabbing my glitter primer. It's going to be a long-ass video. Yes. So a little bit on the back of my hand. I'm grabbing it with a brush and I am going to stamp that basically where I want that orangeness to really, really stick. Okay, then I'm going to go into the shade Window. Then with a different brush, I'm going to go to the shade Uni, which was that greeny shimmer. I'm just going to focus that on the upper part of my eye. It's very colorful today. Yes, I am going to line lashes. And then here is the finished look. I like it. I feel very out there today. Very bold and nature-esque. Which is good because I'm going to play around in nature tonight. So I think Quest is the one that I used. Yes. So let me go over everything that I used very, very quickly. And I will keep on testing all the products that I tried today except the eyeshadow palette. But I will touch on that in a little while. Let's start with the bronzer. I like the product. I like the way that it looks. Maybe I could even have gotten away with the shade Light. Yeah, I think so. So if you are light, medium, but lighter, I think you can use shade 1 as well, if you want to. I will leave the site down below, by the way. But yeah, shade 2, I think it's a pretty shade. And I can see that it is not very, very warm, but it is still warm. Yes, I hope so. But I will keep on trying it, and I will let you know in a future video how I feel about them. Let's go to these two then. Yeah. If you don't like a loose highlighter, you won't like this. However, I don't mind a loose highlighter at all. You get a crap ton of product though. But yeah, is it messy? Yeah, maybe. But I can just pick something up from the cap. You know, pick a little bit up with my brush and then tap off my brush in the cap. And then put it on your face. You can use this to highlight your body if you want to as well. You could use this as an inner corner. You can use it in your nail art. You can, yeah. And I think that the color is stunning. Stunning. I'm going to have, I'm going to love this product so much in this color. Oh, DJ, thank you so much for sending this my way. Honestly. And then the blush. This color, I think that it would look gorgeous on you if you have a cool undertone, because it has a hint of blue in it. I think these two complement each other so well, because in here as well there is kind of that peach, that orangeness, that they just work together so well. And now you can really see the green of my hand, or at least I can see it. But on the cheeks, yeah, it's very pigmented. So if you are of a darker complexion, which she is, so it makes sense that on my pasty skin, I kind of need to go in a little bit slow. If you are very, very fair, you need to go in extremely slow, unless you like a bright cheek. I hope that makes sense. But I really like the formula. I love how it blends out, because it blends out beautifully. Yeah, this is a color that I was looking for. And I had something similar to this, but it was, I did not really like the formula, and I really love the formula on this one. I think it is a nice product to work with, and yeah, again, I'm going to have a lot of fun with this one as well. Now, yeah, if you are darker, oh, this combination would be so stunning, honestly. Yes. Was that everything that was new? No, the eyeshadow palette, yeah. I did not buy this to use a lot. Honestly, it's like I had with the Odin's Eye Norn collection. I bought this because it needed to be in my collection. So I just think it is just... It also, I don't think that you can even see this. Can you see texture? Can you see the texture here? It's how he paints. He paints in texture. And this is like... I think they nailed it. Honestly, I really like Storybook Cosmetics. I like their aesthetic. This is the first palette that I truly tried from them. I like it. Is it the most easy palette to work with? I have easier blues in my collection. I do. These blues are a little bit more sticky. I think these work best if you have a set base, or best, not necessarily, but easier. When I really, really look, I can see a little bit of patchiness. It's user error, because if I am taking a little bit more time, I can fix that patchiness. But I would not necessarily call this a beginner palette. If you want to learn how to work with blue shadows, this is not specifically the palette for you, I think. Just because of how the shades are formulated. Are they bad? No, they are not bad shades at all. But they're probably not the most easy to work with if you are not used to working with color. That is actually what I want to say. Yeah, I'm very happy that I have it in my collection. Yeah. I think that's it. I'm very happy to have it in my collection. If you want to know where to get anything, I will leave them all down below in the description box for you guys. And then that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.